So today is Jack's first squirrel hunt versus Jack going into the backyard and trying to kill my pets. I refer to my squirrels living in the yard as my pets because I don't kill them. I feed them and like to watch them. But anyway, Jack is constantly trying to squirrel hunt. And it's my little tracking dog. But today we're going to try to get him on a squirrel and introducing the new Umarex pellet gun. And I can tell you, I've shot all their pellet guns and every pellet gun under the sun, including Sheridan's growing up, and love shooting pellet guns my whole life. But this is the most accurate and easiest to shoot pellet gun I've ever had. And doesn't come camoed like this. You may have to buy $3 worth of paint yourself to do as good a job as I've done. But at any rate, let's go into timber and have some fun.
The new Umarex Origin 22 caliber pellet gun is probably my favorite that they build. It's deadly accurate. Today I'm hoping to take a squirrel.
Jack smells a deer.
And I've already sighted her in, so I know that at 25 yards you can stack them. All I need now is a fat red squirrel to show himself.
Barking right over here. I'm gonna try to get in close and see if I can get a shot. Come on, Jack.
Now, Jack may be the only friend I have that loves hunting more than I do. He's also the only friend I know of that sleeps with my wife when I'm gone. He's a Patterdale Terrier. And I'm hoping that Jack will get to retrieve his first squirrel today. By the time the squirrel hits the ground, I'm also hoping that maybe there'll be a little life left in the squirrel. For that's what really stimulates a hunting dog.
There he's up here, right up.
I never got a shot at that guy. He made a jump to the other tree and vanished on me. I'm trying to teach Jack to sit quietly beside me while we watch the treetops for squirrels. A deer has walked up on us. He hasn't broke. That's a good sign. Any other day I would head shoot the squirrels, but today I'll try and double lung one so that Jack can get in on the action. Sometime later, we finally spotted a fat red squirrel, and he's coming down the tree right at me. I'll try and stop him and make a good shot. He's hit, but I'll whack him again.
Good boy. Good dog. Good boy. First squirrel. Another
Obviously, Jack doesn't like to share too much. Not long after, we've spotted another squirrel cutting nuts high in the tree. I'm sneaking in close for a shot now. So I'm training Jack to hunt and my wife to film all at the same time. Unfortunately, neither of the two like to listen, so it's very challenging. But this guy's so preoccupied with feeding that he has no clue that we're moving in for the slock. The new Umarex Origin 22 caliber pellet gun is probably my favorite that they build. It's deadly accurate. For the squirrel, life was going just great, until someone put the crosshairs on him. He's about to go to the light, so I'm hoping that Jack will get in on the action before he does. Ouch! Jack got bit, but he's a fighter. And in short time, he's killed the squirrel.
Alright, well, the woods is totally forfeited to the animals at this point, but that's Jack's second squirrel, and by the sounds of it, that's Jack's first squirrel bite, so now he knows it's the real deal. But I body shot both squirrels, which gives them a little longer to live, which gives your dog that much more training. But Jack got his first squirrel. Look at him there. He's just proud as could be. Good boy, Jack. Bring him here. He's gagging on a hair. Anyway, we got our two squirrels this afternoon, and you know, I hunted quite a while here in this timber, and I've only seen about four squirrels. It's a nice cool afternoon, so I'm thinking their numbers are down here. I caught a bobcat in this timber earlier in the year and released him. I probably shouldn't have. So two squirrels are both males, so we're not hurting nothing, and I'm gonna get these guys. I got Jack a little bit of experience today, and couple nice fat squirrels will be good eating. So nothing like squirrel hunting right before deer season starts, whether you're bow hunting or you're hunting with your pellet gun. And I can say that my new Umarex is 3 for 3. I took 3 shots, shot one squirrel twice, shot this guy once, and it's a deadly accurate gun. Now I gotta argue with Jack and get my squirrel and get out of here. Come on, buddy, you gotta give it up. Come on, let's go.
Look at the difference between a mature squirrel and a yearling. These guys here are young and foolish, but the best eating. But these guys are pretty good too if you just cook them a little longer and maybe put a little steam to them. But I love squirrels, old or young. Jack likes him too, even though one bit him today.
Good boy, Jack. Good boy. All right, come on. Let's go get another squirrel.
Hunting with a pellet gun is lots of fun, but so is blowgun hunting. But blowgun hunting is much harder, for you need them close. Really close. so I found that calling the squirrels down the tree works best. This is how I do it. Once you spot the squirrel high in the tree, try to close in beneath him where he can't see you. Shake a branch, then bark at him like another squirrel. I'd say it works about half the time, and when it does, it sure is cool. Darn it, I had a good shot and missed. Shot right under him. Missed again, but the squirrel has no idea what's going on. He still believes that I'm another squirrel. Here he comes. The dart has hit the squirrel, and with razor tips, he's in the tree bleeding to death. It won't be long now.
You don't have to shoot a squirrel off a feeder. You can go in the woods, call them down the tree, and slock them. That's where the dart came out. Bled out quick. razor darts are deadly. Oh yeah. I get a kick out of shooting stuff with my blowgun.
Split that bone, don't cut through the skin. This is a whole squirrel. This squirrel, by the feel of his skin, with this razor sharp cold steel knife, feels to me like he's older than I am. That's a pretty old squirrel. Jack, get back over here. Jack's not quite broke yet.
She's not elk. Here he goes.